This is Kavita Suresh Kumar, and I am going to demonstrate how using the WebSphere Liberty kernel Docker image as the base image, new Docker image can be built with the Daytrader sample application and run the Daytrader sample. Let us start the demo by launching the Docker Quick Start terminal. The default virtual machine already exists and it has got started. The IP address of the virtual machine is 192.168.99.100. This is the IP address we will be using when we access our application running inside the Docker container. Now let us log in to the default virtual machine. Docker, machine, SSH, and then the name of the VM, which is default. Now we are inside the default virtual machine. So for this demo, we are going to use the WebSphere Liberty kernel Docker image as the base image. So let us pull the WebSphere Liberty kernel Docker image from the Docker Hub. So Docker pull WebSphere Liberty colon and the tag name kernel. Image has been successfully pulled. Download a new image for WebSphere Liberty colon kernel. So we are going to use this as a base image and build a new image. So let us go to the Daytrader folder. Here we could see there is a Docker file, and then we have the Daytrader application EAR file, and then we have the database derby jar file, and then the server.xml. Let us review the server.xml. So here we could see the features required by the application, and then we could see the information related to the JDBC driver and the information related to the data source. And then we have the information related to the messaging engine, JMS queue connection factory, JMS topic connection factory, JMS queue, JMS topic, JMS activation spec, etc. Now let us review the Docker file. So in this Docker file, we are going to use the WebSphere Liberty kernel as the base image. And then we are going to copy the server.xml to the default server, then copy the ER file under the drop-ins folder, then copy the derby jar under shared resources data, Daytrader 3 sample derby libs folder, and then we are going to run the install utility install accept license and default server. So what the install utility is going to do is, it is going to review the server.xml under the default server and install the features which are not already available. So now let us build the new Docker image. Docker build minus t and then the name of the image, Daytrader dot. The image is getting built. So it has identified the missing features and it is trying to establish a connection to the configured repositories. Successfully connected to all configured repositories. Started downloading the required features. It has successfully downloaded all the required features and installed them. So now the build is successful and we have a new Daytrader image available. Let us start a new container using the new Docker image which we have built. Docker run is the command to start the container, and hyphen hyphen name and the name of the container, which is the Daytrader sample, and then using the environment variable, we are going to accept the license. And then we are going to do the port mapping, that is 9080 in the host is mapped to the 9080 in the container. Then minus D to specify the container is run in the background. Then minus T and the name of the image. So the container has been successfully started. Let us confirm the container is running successfully by giving docker ps minus a. We could see the container Daytrader sample is up and running. Now let us launch the application in the browser and check. Let us launch the application using the default virtual machine IP address and the port number which we mapped. So the application has been launched successfully. Now let us go to the configuration tab. Click recreate Daytrader database. Database has been successfully created. So now let us change some configuration option. So we are going to create the max users is 1500 and the trade max quotas 1000. Click update config. So now let us go back to the Daytrader main page and click repopulate database. And the database getting repopulated. Database has been populated. Now again, let us go to the DayTrader homepage. Click Trading and Portfolios. So we are going to log in using the UID 0. Click Login. So let us review the various pages in this application. Click Account and review the account information. Now let's go to the portfolio, and here we perform some transactions. And then let us go to the Quotes and Trade, and in this page also let us perform some transaction. Review the home page and then click Log Off. As part of this demo, you have seen how new Docker image with DayTrader sample is built using the WebSphere Liberty kernel image as the base image, and how using the install utility, the features required by the application are downloaded from the repository and installed, and the container started using the new image runs the DayTrader sample successfully. Thanks for watching the demo.